Hello gamers, and thank you for watching. I got my miner Bobcat 300 after a wait of about 6 months. In this video, I'm gonna show you all the bugs I had and difficulties I had to go through when setting it up, so you don't have to keep trying a few days like I did, and maybe even give up. The first parts of the configuration are straightforward. You will have to choose 12 secret words which you need to write down and keep them in a safe place. They will allow you to access the application. While in the app, you have to choose the type of miner that you have. You also see a few tips like a preferable distance that there should be between miners, which is 300 meters, that you need to keep the miner near a window and not have it next to a wall, and to avoid metal meshes. You have something called Diagnostics, which I will show you later on how to access. The next step will be to screw the antenna on and plug the miner power adapter. The next step will be a scan for the hotspot. For this, you have a pin which you can insert in a small hole in the back of your miner next to the Ethernet cable and the other ones. You will be able to scan for the hotspot once it has the blue light on, and you also need to have the Bluetooth on your phone activated. Regarding the Helium app, I noticed it works better on Android rather than iPhone. On iOS it kept crashing and it was super annoying. After the scan, you will see your device, simply select it and select your Wi-Fi. After this, you will be asked to input the location. It's going to notify you that if you change the location, there is a fee of $10, so the first one for the current location is already paid for. You will see onboarding your hotspot message. It is actually recommended that the first time you do this, you should use the internet cable. I had it already attached to a wall, so I did it via Wi-Fi. Here I had an issue, the app kept crashing, so instead of connecting the internet cable, which was close to impossible in my case, I did an upgrade of the app and that did the trick. You can also try using the cable as it could be more stable. I also tried connecting the hotspot via the Bobber app, which again failed for me. I then had another bug. It said Hotspot Miner is waiting to start, may be caused by OTA update or miner restart. Here I restarted the miner and had to wait maybe even an hour, and that did the trick. You will need the MAC address and the IP for the other stuff we're going to do later, so what I did is use the Helium hotspot utility. You have to repeat the process here using the pin, pressing for 5 seconds the small button on the back of your miner, then connecting to the miner with the Helium utility app, and you will see the IP and the MAC address. I took a screenshot of it and I will be using it later. With the IP address of your hotspot miner, you can access the hotspot menu. Insert the IP in your browser and you will see multiple options in the menu. You can see the temperature, you can reset the miner, you can reboot it, and this is just so you know because in some situations you might need to do some of these. If you configured the miner so far and got past some of these bugs, which you might not get or maybe get different ones that I did, you might see this on your screen. It says the miner is relayed. This can affect the mining rate and it is recommended to fix the issue. You have a few videos about this, but none worked for me, so I had to find another solution which fixed the issue for me. Basically, you need to connect to the router and do a port forwarding for the port 44158. The way you do this is connecting your browser to the modem or router that you have, and on the router you will see the IP address you need to insert. Here it will ask you for a password, which again is written on the back of your router. Now here it's going to differ according to the company of the router that you have. In my case, I had to go to applications and select port forwarding. Here we have the one which I did not touch. The description is not mandatory, and then you will see here public port twice. Some will only have one. For people that see it twice, you need to enter the same value twice. It's basically a range and you need to specify only one number. The IP to be inserted here is the one that we saw earlier. The private port will be again the same one, 44158, inserted twice. And the protocol will be TCP, which is the one that resends the packages if some don't arrive. And the UDP is most common for voice messages and similar, so we won't choose it here. One thing you must pay attention to is to enable this, select enable and that's it. Now, in this case, for most of you guys, this will be enough. I restarted the router and also the miner, which means plug it off and then plug it in again, and in a few minutes it should be okay. If this doesn't work for you, you can try searching for UPnP and select disable. This one allocates IPs from what I could read, and some users said it was useful for them. So if you still have issues, try disabling the UPnP option. To check if the port is open, you can also use ugetsignal.com/tools/open-ports. It's on the left side on your menu. The IP address will autocomplete and you only need to insert the port number, which is 44158. If it says open, then that's great. If not, we have another option here, which did the trick for me. So if you like what you're seeing so far, then please take a 1 second break to like the video and also subscribe in order to support the channel. I logged in my internet provider account on their website and selected Dynamic DNS. Here I inserted a name that wasn't taken by others. I had to look up on my router interface DHCP static leases. Here I inserted a MAC and IP of my miner hotspot, and in the DDNS settings I had to insert in the host the name I inserted earlier on my internet provider website. The one I inserted earlier when configuring the dynamic DNS. After this, I needed to restart the router and also the miner, but this didn't do the trick, it didn't work, it wasn't enough. So I sent a request to my internet provider to open the port and also call them. And they replied saying I needed to restart the router, which I already did, and that they restarted it again and that it's okay. And indeed it was, the port is now open and I noticed from the first day a higher mining rate. We see now how the miner should look in its perfect state, online and nothing more. And we can see it also made more the following day after configuring the port. If you want to, I can make a video showing my earnings with a standard antenna in my location so you guys can have a clear idea. Hope this video worked well for you. Thank you very much for watching the entire video. Don't hesitate to like the video and subscribe, and I wish you all the best. Goodbye.